Hello everyone, welcome back in lecture series on topic solid state. In previous videos, we have studied characteristics of solid state. Solid is a state of matter and it has a definite volume. Solids have definite volume, definite mass, definite shape. Interparticle forces are very strong and particle space is very less, close packing is there, and therefore solids are not compressible. And these solids are classified into two types mainly, that is crystalline and amorphous. And this classification of solid into crystalline and amorphous, it is based on the arrangement of the constituent particles. Now, solids are made up of atom, ion or molecule. Particles means atom, ion or molecule. And depending upon the arrangement of the constituent particles, these solids are classified as a crystalline and amorphous. Now, in case of crystalline solids, the particles, that means atom, ions or molecules, these are arranged in a regular repeating pattern. And this regular repeated arrangement extends over a long range. But in case of amorphous solids, this arrangement is not regular. So this is the main difference between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. So crystalline solids are the solids in which constant particles are arranged in a definite repeating pattern. That means these particles are regular, these are arranged in a regular fashion, the arrangement is periodic. And because of this regular repeated arrangement of the particle, solids have a definite, crystalline solids have definite geometrical shape. And you have also studied in previous lecture that is crystals have a definite number of faces, a definite number of edges, a definite angle is there. So why these crystals have definite geometrical shape? How the constituent particles are arranged in the crystal? What kind of geometrical shape is possible? All these points we will study in this lecture. So today we will discuss about the crystal structure, how this crystal is formed and it got a particular geometrical shape. So to understand this concept of crystal structure, we must know some basic concepts such as lattice points, bases, unit cell, all these you must No. So let us see what is meant by lattice. The order, three-dimensional arrangement of particles in a crystal is nothing but the lattice. So lattice means, suppose, see here, this is the ordered arrangement. It is two-dimensional, but if it extends in all directions, all the three directions on the three axis, x axis, y axis and z axis, then you will get a three dimensional arrangement of the particle. And this regular ordered three dimensional arrangement of the particle is nothing but the lattice. So, and the points in this lattice, this represent the position of the constituent particles in the crystal. The position of atom, ion or molecule is shown by these points. And these points are called the lattice points. So what is lattice? Geometrical arrangement of points in three-dimensional periodic array is known as lattice. And a crystal structure is obtained by attaching the constituent particles to the each of the lattice point. These are the lattice points. Crystal structure is obtained by attaching the constituent, that means atom, ion or molecule, to these lattice points. Now, how these are obtained? See here. If you join these lattice points, these are points to be joined kele by straight line, then you will get a specific shape. If you join these four points like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, if you join these four particles, that is four points, lattice points, then you will get a cubic shape. If you extend it three dimensionally, you will get what? Cubic shape. So these are the lattice points. Here's a points this type. That is the point at intersection of two or more lines. Each line hai, if you attach, if you join these two points, and if you join these two points, then the intersection of this line and this line is called as what? The lattice point. Kiwa ha baga ithe. He line and he line yana intersect karnara, ya teen line na intersect karnara ha jo point ahe, to mhanje lattice point. So, point at intersection of two or more line is nothing but a lattice point. So, by joining these straight lines, you will get what? The point of point at intersection is nothing but lattice point. So, what is basis? Basis means the constituent particles associated with each lattice point. प्रत्येक lattice point वर जो atom, ion किंवा molecule किंवा group of atom असेल तर त्याला काय म्हणायचं? Basis of crystal lattice. So constituent particle मग ते atom असतील, ion असतील किंवा group of atom असू शकेल किंवा molecule असू शकेल. So constituent particle associated with each lattice point, hey, lattice points chale. Ani ya pratyek point var associate zalela jo atom kiwa group of atom asel kiwa set of atom asel, tyala kay mhanaycha? Basis. And lattice and basis, they form crystal structure. Lattice and basis form what? Crystal structure like this. See here. Suppose these are the lattice points. If you join these two points, then you will get a particular shape. If you go on joining these points, lattice point, then you will get what? Such a type of a lattice. And if you extend these joining, then you will get what? A three-dimensional structure. And that three-dimensional structure is known as what? The regular repeated arrangement of the particles, that is nothing but lattice, crystal lattice, or it is called as a space lattice. If the arrangement is three-dimensional, then it is called as a space lattice or crystal lattice. So, and here what happens? Basis means, basis acquires this point at intersection of these lines. If you join these lines, then this is the point at intersection of these four lines, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and at this point particle is attached, atom, ion or molecule, that is the position of the particle, constituent particle, and that is called as a basis. So how the crystal structure is formed? Lattice plus basis, it forms what? Such a type of a crystal structure. At every lattice point, basis are there, constituent particles are arranged, and the whole structure is known as crystal structure. So here, this every point in this lattice, this is the lattice point, this is one is the lattice point, and these two lattice points are joined. and on this lattice point atoms, molecules or group of atom is attached, that is called as a basis. And this arrangement gives, when you attach, when you join this lattice point, then you will get a particular arrangement, particular geometrical shape. And the smallest unit obtained by joining this lattice unit, that is called as a unit cell. So unit cell is the smallest repeating structural unit. This unit is, this shape is repeated. If you go on attaching these lines, then you will get what? The same structure is obtained. This is the spaced lattice or the crystal lattice. And the shape of the crystal lattice is same as that of the shape of the unit cell. Geometric shape of the crystal lattice is same as the geometric shape of the unit cell, because unit cell is a building block of the crystal lattice. That means, you know, it's just like a wall. Ekhadya bhinticha building block ka asto tar brick asto. Tar bricks apan ekmekavar rachvat jato ani wall tayar hote. The smallest unit ka jala tar ti bricks. So here it is the smallest, and he unit repeat hote. So it is, unit cell is the smallest repeating structural unit, which is repeated over and over, again and again, in all direction. He is a unit, he repeats, it is a building block that repeats over and over, again and again, in all directions. Ya direction ne, ya direction ne, var, sagra side ne. Then that is called, in all direction in the crystal lattice is known as what? The unit. Remember that achar bares vela question asto, what is unit cell? Define unit cell. So unit cell is the smallest repeating structural unit of crystalline solid. Now when these unit cells are stacked together, ekmekavar apan vadhavat gelo ani arrange kele, if these unit cells are arranged one over other, that is, it is, these are stacked together, then it generates what? A crystal. And each unit cell, pratyek unit cell, it share its face, edges and corners with the neighboring unit cell. Shezarcha unit cell barobar kay kay share karto ha unit cell, tar face he baka. This is the face, plane surface, edges and corners. This unit cell share its face with this unit cell. Also, it share its edges with this unit cell, and the unit cell which is on back side. Also, it share this unit cell with this unit cell and this unit cell. So, unit cell, when these are stacked together, they generate a crystal, and each unit cell share its faces, edges and corners with the neighboring unit cell. So this is what the arrangement of the crystal lattice or spaced lattice. This is called as a spaced lattice or crystal lattice. And the shape of the unit cell, it depends upon the length of three edges and angles of the unit cell. See here, this is a unit cell, and the shape of the unit cell, it depends upon what? The edges, three edges, A, this is the A, B and C, length of the unit cell, height of the unit cell and width of the unit cell, so or breadth of the unit cell. These are the three edges, A, B and C. These are the dimensions of the unit cell along the three axes. And alpha, beta and gamma, these are the angles of the unit C. Angle between C and B is denoted by alpha. Angle between A and B is denoted by gamma. And angle between A and C is denoted by beta. So these are the angles of the unit C. And depending upon the length of the unit cell, depending upon the length of these three edges, not unit cell, depending upon the length of these three edges and angle between these edges, different crystal systems are there. There are about seven crystal systems are there that we will study in next lecture. And 14, these lattice points, these are the points that are called as a lattice point. And these lattice points can be arranged in 14 different ways and that are called as a 14 Bravais lattice. 14 possible arrangements are there of lattice. And there are four types of unit cell. These unit cells are of four types. We will see one by one. First, that is primitive or simple unit cell. In this type of unit cell, constituent particle, that means atom, ion or molecule, they are present at its corner. See here, this is a cube shape, is there, unit cell, cubic unit cell, and the constituent particle, that is atoms, ions or molecule, these are present at the corners. Here, how many corners are there to this cube? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 corners are there. And the particles are arranged at 8 corners. Three-dimensional arrangement is like this. At the corner, these particles are present at 8 corners. So remember here that in case of primitive, atishya mahatvacha point ha, which are bharpur veda question vicharlele ahet. So it is very important, note down this point, that is unit cells are of four types and the first type is primitive or simple unit cell, and in case of simple unit cell, constituent particles are present at its corner. Fakta corner la astat, adhimadhe kuthehi nasat nahi. Next, that is type of unit cell, that is body centered unit cell. In body-centered unit cell, one constituent particle is present at the center of its body. And in addition to this, at the eight corners, corner particles are there. See here. It is also cubic crystal, and in that, in a cubic unit cell, and here at the eight corners, at the corners, particles are there, and at the center of the body, one particle is there. So see here, at the eight corners, eight particles are there. And that is, at the center, one single particle is there. So, in body-centered unit cell, one constituent particle is present at the center of its body. And in addition to this particle, corner particles are also there. At eight corners, eight particles are there. Third type, that is face-centered unit cell. So in this, constituent particles are present at the center of each face. In addition to corner particle, म्हणजे corner particle तर आहेतच, आणि या शिवाय जी या cube ची सहा faces आहेत, 1, 2, top चा face, bottom चा face, side ची दोन faces, चार झाली, front चा आणि back sides, so 6 faces are there and 8 corners are there, so at the 8 corner particles is there and Along with that, in addition to this 8, one particle is present at the each face, at the center of the each face. सहा फेसेस आहेत, त्याच्यामुळे सहा पार्टिकल्स आहेत. याप्रमाणे थ्री डायमेन्शनल अरेंजमेंट असेल. सो ॲट ईच फेस वन पार्टिकल इज देअर अँड ॲट द कॉर्नर एट पार्टिकल्स आर देअर. सो इन फेस सेंटर युनिट सेल कॉन्स्टंट पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेझेंट ॲट द सेंटर. आपण फक्त पोझिशन बघतो, नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल नाही बघत आहोत, ते नंतर बघणार. So, in face center unit cell, constituent particles are present at the center of each face, and in addition to this, corner particles are there. At eight corners, eight particles are there. And fourth type, that is base center unit cell. In base center unit cell, constituent particles are present at the center of any two opposite faces. हे अतिशय महत्त्वाचं आहे. पार्टिकल्स कुठे असतात? तर ॲट द सेंटर ऑफ एनी टू अपोजिट फेसेस. म्हणजे दोन साईडचे फेसेस असू शकतील किंवा टॉप आणि बॉटमचं फेस, फक्त अपोजिट फेसला असली पाहिजेत. ॲट द सेंटर ऑफ अपोजिट फेसेस इन ॲडिशन टू कॉर्नर पार्टिकल. कॉर्नर पार्टिकल सगळ्यातच आहेत. सो हिअर लाईक दिस अरेंजमेंट इज देअर. पार्टिकल अरेंजमेंट इज लाईक दिस. ॲट द एट कॉर्नर एट पार्टिकल्स आर and two particles are there at the center of opposite face, center of any two opposite face. आता ही दाखवली आहे ती टॉपचं आणि बॉटमचं फेसच्या सेंटरला दाखव. ही अशी असू शकते. सो दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ बेस सेंटर्ड युनिट सेल. सो कॉन्स्टंट पार्टिकल्स आर प्रेझेंट ॲट द सेंटर ऑफ एनी टू सेंटर ऑफ any two its opposite faces in addition to corner particle. So this is about the types of unit cell. In next lecture we will study 7 types of crystal system and 14 Brevius lattice. So thank you for watching the video.